how do I know how high the camera should be? Then I go back to the perspective view and apply the symmetry modifier to model a second wall. Click detach, name detach object door. Hi there. In this tutorial, we're gonna model a room based on just one single photo. And in this photo, we have walls, we have ceiling, floor, window, furniture, and things like table, chairs, carpet, paintings, vases, lamps, and curtains. To model all of these things, we need to add this reference to a scene and set up a camera with the same view. So let's go ahead and create a camera and select the standard camera, which is Corona Cam. Now, the only thing you should definitely do is uncheck the target box. And now in the top view, or any other view, go ahead and create a camera that looks ahead. Select this window and press C. And now this window will display the camera view. And then when I press Alt B, here is the viewport configuration window. I click on the background tab, and you can also open this window via the menu. So just head over to views, then viewport configuration and background tab. All right, so now we need to select a file. And I go ahead and check the Use Files box, then click on Files and select our photo. Next, I click Apply to Active View, since we're currently in the camera view window. Our image has applied precisely to this window. But as you can see, the image has stretched over the entire window. So first of all, we need to set up a camera resolution. So I head over to Render Setup and then go to the Common tab. And in the Output Size field, select Custom. Then enter the width and height in pixels. And I already know the size of our image. It's 1668 by 2048 pixels. And we need to make a vertical image without any distortion. And I'm going to switch on the Save Frames mode and select Corona Camo 1, show Save Frames. The viewport now fits the image, as you can see. And now we have a yellow border line over here. All right, so next we need to rotate the camera so that it displays the same view as the photo. So I go to Utilities, and then Perspective Match, and then click Show Vanishing Lines. And here we can see that these lines, against the perspective grid. The blue lines are verticals, and we position them along the vertical lines in the image. And as you can see, while I'm doing it, the camera is shifting. And so this way we get the perspective we require. Now red lines are horizontal lines, and I put them along the table and also along the window frame, like so. Now for green lines, the green lines are for these pictures here that indicate a perspective line that recedes into the distance. And I'm doing this very carefully because I want to position the lines properly. The table edge must align with the y-axis. And once again, this is a very meticulous process that will determine the dimensions of objects. Okay, so I put the green lines along the table edge and along the pictures. The horizontal lines are on the window and on the table, and I'm shifting this line all over the place. And it's positioned correctly, and now I'm shifting these lines here to see if everything matches. Okay, and so now that we've done the check, we can fixate the camera to prevent it from shifting. And you should pay attention that the grid surface is at zero level at the moment. It appears to be sitting on the table. Keeping the mouse wheel pressed, I'm lowering the grid. Now, how do I know how high the camera should be? In any scene, there's an object that you can use as a reference. Let's take this table, for example. The height of a standard table is about 7,500 millimeters. And we can also use the chair seat. The height of a chair leg is about 450. Another reference is the wall. It's about 2,750 millimeters high, or maybe a little bit more. And I'm gonna add several objects to the scene and create a box that is 450 millimeters high. And it's gonna be the base of the chair. Let's make it 450 by 450. This structure is basically a space limited by the chair seat and the chair legs. And I shift the camera behind a bit, so that the structure is put where the chair is. See? The camera repeats perspective distortions. Now, I switch on to the default shading mode. And this is our object here. Now let's create a reference box of the table. Let's create another box. The table is about 750 millimeters high. And the tabletop has a corner here. So I shift the box just as well, and I switch on the transparency mode for convenience sake. And then press F4 to enable edges faces. I created the object at a zero level. Its height is 750 millimeters. Lower the camera a little bit more and reduce the length of our reference box and also align it along the y-axis. And so the back and the front edges of the table match, as you can see. So now I increase the width and the side edges match as well. So the tabletop is at the height of 750 millimeters and is confined by this box. This reference box matches the volume of the chair. Now let's add a wall. So let's go ahead and stretch it to the wall, and then there we go, stretch it up. Its height's about 2800. It's a provisional value, and now I'm gonna adjust it. So press Alt X to switch on the transparency mode. If we shift the wall like this, we end up too far from this edge, and I need to align the bottom part. Seeing that there's a baseboard, I leave a gap here. 2800 millimeters is too much. I'm reducing the height of the box until this line aligns with the corner. So this height seems optimal to my eye. Now, if the wall doesn't fit in, we can always check other objects. As we know, our table is 750 millimeters high, but maybe, just maybe we can make it slightly higher. So I change the height to 790. Then I lower the camera so that the tabletop is positioned properly. And we can see the wall looks better now. Then I change the table height to 800 millimeters and adjust the camera accordingly. See? The wall looks even better now. Okay, now we can model the walls, the ceiling, and the floor. I'd like to take the occasion to talk about our big training course if you want to master 3D visualization at a professional level. I invite you to join our full training course. Hundreds of people have already completed it. You'll become a true expert in 3D visualization. Within only 2 months, you'll master 3D Max and Corona Render, and you will learn how to create renders that you're seeing on your screen right now. All of these are our students' graduation works. So go ahead and click the link under the video and sign up for the course. Now let's get on with the room modeling. To model the walls, I head over to perspective window. Select the wall object and convert it to editable poly. Then I select this side polygon over here, keeping shift pressed, stretch it out, and then stretch out this polygon. I go to this window to see how much I need to stretch it. The window starts somewhere around here, so this is where I stop. Then I go back to the perspective view and apply the symmetry modifier to model a second wall. This wall won't be visible, so it's provisional. Collapse modifier stack, collapse two, yes. Now I need to add the floor. And I create a plane, switch on 3D snaps. And you need to have the vertex box and the enable axis constraints box checked. I use this yellow cross here to stretch out the plane. So this plane over here will be our floor. And I'm gonna go ahead and call it floor. And these are our walls. And now we need to model a ceiling. I copy this plane and shift it up. I'll call it ceiling. Use the shell modifier to set the outer amount value. Now convert the ceiling to editable poly again. This allows us to collapse the stack modifier. Now I lower the ceiling using 3D snaps. Select the point and snap. Snap it to another point. Select group of points and snap it to the upper part of the wall. I shift these points here in the exact same way. Now we only need to model the opposite wall so that light from the window falls correctly and repeatedly reflects from that wall. Now pay attention that the camera is outside the room model. And I click on point selection and stretch out the walls to include the camera within the model. And I do the same with the floor, convert it to poly, and click edge selection and do a double click on the extreme edge and stretch it out. With 3D snap switched on, I align the floor with the walls. And the same goes for the ceiling. Select the extreme points of the ceiling and stretch them out. And here I'm gonna add a shape that looks like a door. Now using 3D snaps, I lower this edge to the very bottom. And then I press F12, and in this menu we can move the object based on the entered values. I set the door height to 2000 along the Z. See, this edge shifted up to 2000 millimeters. Now I press F3 to switch on transparency mode. And then I select two opposite polygons and click bridge. And because there will be a door here, a standard shape won't do. We need a slightly different shape. I press Alt Q to isolate the wall. And then I add a 50 millimeter inset. Switch on Select and uniform scale, as well as use selection center. And then I press F2 to display the highlighted polygon. Keeping shift press, I scale it along the Y. Alright, so we've modeled the wall and the door element. So then, keeping control pressed, I select this polygon over here, and then, keeping control pressed, I do a double click on the next loop of polygons. And I keep shift pressed and do scaling. So this is the object that we've modeled. To repaint it, I need to detach the door polygons from the wall. By repeatedly clicking on Grow, I'm increasing the selection area. Now the entire object is selected. Keeping Alt pressed, I remove the selection from the polygons that make up the wall. Click Detach. Name detach object door, and I repaint the wall to light gray. The door won't be within the camera view, it's provisional. However, we're gonna need this door for repeated light reflection. Select horizontal edges and click connect. Lower them until there's a 100-150 millimeters to the bottom edge. Select opposite polygons and click bridge. Paint the walls into that light gray color. And this is provisional color. We're gonna work with materials in other lessons. So I paint the ceiling white. Go to the Corona cam view. See? Now we have the ceiling, our walls, floor, and reference boxes of the table and the chair. All right, so in the next lesson, we're gonna model a window. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you then.